Voices in the Wind Audio Theater presents Sleeping Beauty, dramatized for audio by Diane Vandenhoven and George Czar, and directed by George Czar.
Hazel! Hazel! I'm just bursting with news!
Daphne, stop flapping around and take a breath. I can't hear you with all that buzzing of your fairy wings.
Oh, certainly. Ready, set, land! There. Do you find that an improvement?
Yeah, so do my ears. Look, we're fairies the size of flies. But boy, we got us some noisy wings. You were bursting with news?
Yes, it's a girl. It's a girl.
What's a girl?
What I'm trying to convey is that Queen Amethyst has given birth to a baby girl.
Wonderful news!
Listen, I detect Marigold is approaching.
We're small, but you can hear our wings a mile away.
Make room for me to land, sisters.
As long as it's not on my head like last time.
Ready, set, land.
Ta-da! Oh, I have a message for Hazel from...
Marigold, have you been informed of the news?
Informed? News? What?
The princess is a girl.
A princess is a girl? Well, I learn something new every day. But here, I have a message for Hazel from...
Listen, sisters, there's sure to be a christening for the new baby.
Do you think we'll be requested to be in attendance, Hazel?
Oh, yeah, for sure. After all, we've been official royal caretakers of the woods since before King Florestan was born.
But it's an honorary position. As official royal caretakers of the woods, we only have the responsibility of...
of looking at the trees. A lot. You know, I've got a message for Hazel from...
But it's an honor to be official royal caretakers of the woods, Daphne.
But we don't do anything, Hazel.
Sure we do, Daphne. We look at trees.
A lot.
I'll be honest, sisters. They felt we were getting too old for three fairies. We can't cast as many spells as we used to. They wanted to stick us where we wouldn't be in the way. Out here in a cottage in the woods. It's kind of like they don't want us around anymore.
Oh? Really? Then I won't give you the message from the castle.
What message? From the castle? Give me that.
And a princess. And?
Listen to this. Dear Hazel, Daphne, and Marigold, you are hereby summoned to the royal castle as guests on the occasion of the christening of our new child, Princess Aurora.
They've disposed of us to this forest, but apparently didn't forget us totally.
How cool is that? I mean, we haven't been invited to any sort of fancy party since I cast that spell and set the royal advisor's umbrella on fire.
We've got to have something fancy to wear for such a big deal event. We have to conjure up our finest gowns.
But Hazel, we haven't worn our elegant apparel since
the wedding.
Certainly the wedding.
What wedding?
The wedding of King Florestan and Queen Amethyst.
Don't you have a recollection of what occurred, Marigold?
Oh, yes. I remember I ate a delicious slice of chocolate cake. Yum.
I'm not referring to the cake, Marigold.
How can you not remember? She showed up.
Uninvited.
Oh, you mean Tourmaline, the evil fairy?
Shh! Don't say her name.
Who? Tourmaline?
Quiet! She may have spies lurking all around.
She has round spies?
Her spies aren't round, Marigold.
She was...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.